Hello everyone and welcome to Unwind with Janet. Today I will be making for you a very unique dish, and that fruit tree is still in my yard today where I grew up. I'm talking about none other than our beloved ackee. It's a part of our Jamaica's national dish. It's not like any other fruit that you know, and that is why it is so special to us. Ackee is prepared with saltfish, otherwise known as codfish, and it creates our award-winning national dish, ackee and saltfish. The fruit is from Africa, the fish is from Europe, but because of the creativity of our islanders, the combination is definitely Jamaican. It's cooked with a medley of vegetables and herbs, among other enhancing ingredients. So come let me show you how we do it. Welcome back. Now, in order for me to prepare this mouth-watering Jamaican ackee and saltfish, I have a bowl of canned ackee, a couple of pieces of saltfish, onion powder, chopped garlic, a bowl with my vegetables, some thyme, seasoning salt, black pepper, and salt if needed. Normally, I bring my water to a boil. The fish can be added in the cold water if you choose to. Some people just soak it overnight in a bowl of room temperature water. So there's no wrong or right way to do this, okay? Now, I normally boil my fish for between 15 to 20 minutes. You have to make sure that you half mask the pot or half cover it, because if not, it's going to be a big mess in the end and you don't want that. The canned ackee is basically cooked, but I prefer to let it boil for about 2 minutes with the saltfish. Sometimes there are some hard pieces in it that I don't like, and that's the reason why I add it to the salt water. You can choose to run it under hot water from the tap, while on the other hand, some people just cook it as is. And because the ackee has a mild flavor, it tends to take a good amount of vegetables, such as your bell pepper, Scotch bonnet pepper, your onion, scallion, tomato, as well as other powder seasoning to really get it to that perfect taste. Now, one of the reasons why I enjoy preparing ackee and saltfish is because it's so easy to prepare. It's one of my go-to dishes when I just want to whip something up quickly in the kitchen. I do not have to spend too much time cutting up and seasoning and marinating. This is just like a 1, 2, 3 done. It's as simple as that. Trust me, this can be done in less than 30 minutes. So now that the codfish or saltfish has been boiled and it's ready, and I must point out, I'm using the boneless saltfish. You can purchase the bone-in one if you choose to. You're just gonna pick it up just like this. I do not get them too fine. I like chunky pieces, because when you're eating it, you will be able to really have a good combination of the flavor in your mouth of both ackee and saltfish. If it's too fine, it might get too trashy in the end. All right, make we run the boat. In other words, let's cook. So in a heated skillet now, you're gonna add your oil, and after that, you're gonna drop your veggies and your herbs, and you're gonna saute for about 2 minutes on medium heat. Nothing higher, because the last thing you want is when you're eating your ackee and saltfish is to taste burnt vegetable. All we're trying to do now is to just extract that flavor from the vegetables just by sauteing them. So on medium heat, and you're going to do this for about 2 minutes, nothing more. And as you can see, I also use a generous amount of oil, and the measurement will be in the description below, because I want that to be the only liquid that forms my gravy. I won't be adding any water or ketchup or anything like that. And at any point, if you don't think you have enough, you can always add some more, but make sure it cooks a little bit before you turn the stove off. So now that your vegetables have been sauteed and all the flavors have been combined, now is the time when you're going to add your saltfish or your codfish, just like this. And after that, you're just going to give it a good stir just to make sure that you've got everything combined. Now, I season my ackee and saltfish in 2 different stages. So first, I will season the saltfish with some of the powdered season. So I had my onion powder, a little of the black pepper, and a little of the seasoning salt. I think it adds another level of flavor to the finished dish. But let me know how you prepare yours. Do you put everything together, or do you separate it and season it just like this? So I totally forgot to add my garlic, and I'm adding it at this point. Normally I would add it with the rest of the vegetables and have it sauteed together, but hey, it's better late than never. You'll still get the flavor from that garlic. So after you're through with seasoning up your saltfish, you don't have to let it cook for any amount of time. You just add your ackee to it. And then after that, you're just gonna add all your remaining powdered seasonings. You have to be careful now. You do not want to stir your ackee too much, because you do not want a mushy looking type of ackee and saltfish. You want to know that some of your ackee are still intact. You're gonna get a few that are gonna be soft. So you have to be very, very gentle when you're stirring your ackee at this point. And then you cover, and I would say give it about 2 minutes. You don't need anything more. And then it's all done and ready for you. So in Jamaica, ackee and saltfish is usually served as breakfast, but it can be served as dinner also, and that's what I did. So go ahead and give it a try and let me know how it turned out. Leave your comments in the comment box. Thank you everyone for watching. I hope you liked this video. And if you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss next week's video. What good? Till we see you next time, all right?